Hello everyone, welcome to Inno Tutorial Civil Engineering Construction video. In this video, we are going to learn how to lay out columns in AutoCAD plan, that is how to properly arrange columns in a building plan. Now as you can see, I'm going to be using this building plan as an example, and this is a 3-bedroom bungalow. So I'm going to be using this as an example, and we are going to be placing columns on this plan. So let me zoom in so that we can see this properly. So as you can see, this is a 3-bedroom bungalow. So this is the first room, that is bedroom 1, bedroom 2, and this is bedroom 3, and this is a master bedroom, because as you can see, we also have a bath inside the bedroom. So this is the rear elevation of the bungalow. This is the right elevation. Then this is the roof plan. This is the left elevation, while this is the front elevation. So we don't care about that. All we care about right now is the plan, that is the floor plan. Now, when placing columns in building plan, there are three things you need to know. And if you know these three things, then you will be able to properly place columns in a building plan. Now the first thing you need to know is you always need to arrange your column in a symmetrical pattern, that is in a symmetrical way, because this is going to save you a lot of time and it is going to be very easy for you to model the column in your building design software like ETABS, like SAP 2000. So the first thing you need to know is always arrange your column in a symmetrical pattern. Secondly, you need to check for the maximum distance from one column to another column, and the maximum distance from one column to another column should not exceed 7.5 meters. So if you have a distance exceeding 7.5 meters, that is from one column to another column, then you should add another column in order to reduce the span, because if the distance is more than 7.5 meters, meaning we are going to have bending moments on the beam, because the beam will run across the column. So if it is more than 7.5 meters, we are going to have bending moments on the beam. And when we have bending moments on the beam, that is when we have too much bending moment on the beam, meaning this can cause the beam to fail. And if the beam fail, it can also cause the column to fail. And if the column fail, you know what can happen? The building might collapse. So that is why we always need to check for the maximum distance from one column to another column. And finally, when placing the column, try to place the column on every corner of the room. So if you have a bedroom, try to place the column on every corner of the room. So we are going to be placing the column. So if you take a look at bedroom 2, we can place column on every corner of the room. So we can place one column here, we can place another column at this location, we can place another column at this location, and also we can place another column at this location. So if you also consider the length, so as you can see, this is not exceeding 7.5 meters, so it is okay. And also if you consider this length, as you can see over here, this is not exceeding 7.5 meters, so it is good. So I'm going to quickly place the column on the plan, then I'm going to show you how the column have been placed. So as you can see, we have placed the columns on the plan. So let me zoom in so that you can see this. So as you can see, I have placed column on every corner of the room. We have one column at this location, we have one column at this location, we have one column here, we also have one column at this location. Then if you take a look at master bedroom, now this is what you need to know. If for example, look at this master bedroom, and for this master bedroom, we have a bath inside this master bedroom. So whenever you have something like this, what you need to do is you need to take everything as a whole and take everything as one single room, then place the columns at the corner of the room. So as you can see, for this master bedroom, we also have a bath here. So what I did is I took the master bedroom and the bath, I took everything as a single room. Then I place column at D. Then I place column at every corner. So I place one column here, place one column here, place one column here. Then also I place one column at this location, then place one column at this location. So as you can see, these columns are arranged in a symmetrical pattern. As you can see, these columns are arranged in a symmetrical pattern. As you can see. So for bedroom 3, you also need to place column at every corner. So as you can see, place column at every corner. And as you can see, this is arranged in a symmetrical pattern. Then this is the window, so we cannot place column here. So as you can see, it is arranged in a symmetrical pattern. In a symmetrical pattern, look at it. So for kitchen, so as you can see, we have kitchen, we have a veranda here. What you need to do is you need to take everything as a single unit. So you take everything as a single unit and you place column at every corners. Then while placing this column, you also need to check for the maximum spacing. As you can see over here, this is not exceeding 7.5 meters, so it is okay. So if it is exceeding 7.5 meters, then you need to add another column in order to reduce the span length. So that is very, very important. So, and as you can see, this column is arranged in a symmetrical pattern. If you take a look at this, it's arranged in a symmetrical pattern. Take a look at this, it's arranged in a symmetrical pattern. So this is restroom. So we have the restroom here. So what I did is I took this as a single unit as well. So as you can see, I took this as a single unit. So I placed one column here, one column here, one column here, and one column here. And obviously this span length is not greater than 7.5 meters, so it is okay. Then let's move to the dining room. So for the dining room, place one column here, place one column here. So place one column at every corner. So one here, place one column here. And so because as you can see, for the lodge, I place one column at every corner. Look at it, one column here, one column here, one column here, one column here, and also one column here. So for dining room, you don't need to place any column here, because of course the span length is going to be too short, so there's no need to place any column at this location. So this column is going to be sufficient enough, so you can just place one column here, place one column here, and also place one column at this location. Then this column is going to be for the lodge, so it's going to be sufficient enough, so there is no need to place another column at this location because the span length is going to be too short. Then we have the veranda. So we place one column here. So as you can see, we place one column here, then we place one column here, we place one column here, and also we place one column here. So at every corners, and make sure the span length is not greater than 7.5 meters. So that is basically it. So these are the column placement. So this is how we place the columns, and I hope it is clear enough. So I hope it was helpful. If you have any question, maybe there's any part you don't understand, then you can let me know in the comment section, then we can discuss more about it. So with that being said, this is going to be the end of this video, and please, if you like the video, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel Inno Tutorial by clicking the red subscribe button below this video. And with that being said, you all have a good and a wonderful day. God bless you all. Bye-bye.